Good morning, friends at Blue Water. If you haven't seen me yet, my name is Craig Freer. I am the transitional pastor at the Kingsfield Zurich Mennonite Church right next door to you. For my devotional thoughts with you today, I want to start with the story of one of the most famous and loved old hymns of ours came to be. The song is "It Is Well With My Soul," and it was written by a man named Horatio Spafford. He was an attorney in Chicago, and he and his wife Anna and their four daughters enjoyed a wonderful life there in Chicago. Then, tragically, in the Great Chicago Fire of 1871, he lost most of his business. It was destroyed in the fire. Then, around 2 years after that, while his wife and daughters were on a trip to Europe on an ocean liner, the ocean liner hit another ship, and it sank, and all four of his daughters passed away and were lost. His wife survived, and 9 days later, because they didn't have phones and emails like we do today, he received a telegraph from his wife saying, "Saved alone, what shall I do?" Well, Spafford took the next available ship to join his wife, and while he was on the passage across the Atlantic, the captain of the ship notified Spafford that they were coming to the place where the ship went down. As he stood there, looking at the waters where the ship went down, reflecting over the course of his life and the journey that he's been on, he penned then the words of this beloved hymn. "When peace like a river attendeth my way, when sorrows like peace or like sea billows roll, whatever my lot, Thou hast taught me to say, it is well with my soul. It is well with my soul. It is well with my soul. Though Satan should buffet, though trial should come, let this blessed assurance control, that Christ has regarded my helpless estate and has shed his own blood for my soul. My sin, oh, the bliss of this glorious thought, my sin, not in part, but the whole, is nailed to the cross, and I bear it no more. Praise the Lord, O my soul. And Lord, haste the day when my faith shall be sight, the clouds be rolled back as a scroll, the trump shall resound, and the Lord shall descend. Even so, it is well with my soul. It is well with my soul. It is well with my soul." It reminds me of the passage from 2 Corinthians chapter 1, verses 3 to 4, where we read these words: "Praise be to the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of compassion and the God of all comfort, who comforts us in our troubles, so that we can comfort those in any trouble with the comfort we ourselves have received from God." The idea of comfort, when you think about it, really implies two people. There's a person who is in need, and there's a person who can provide comfort. The one who gives the comfort and the one who receives the comfort. It also implies a need. We know that in this fallen world we live in, troubles and trials come. There's times when we are in need of comfort. And so God, knowing our need, knowing that there would be trouble in this world, created us with this capacity to both receive comfort, but also to give it. Because we live in a world where we need it. God is not bound in time in the same way that human beings are. He exists outside of time, but we're different. And we tend to live in three dimensions. We live in the past, we live in the present, and then we live in the future. We can remember and suffer through previous distresses, previous difficulties and sadnesses. We can be filled with grief and regrets from the past. And so we can live in that place and need comfort in that place. We can reflect on those things and worry and be anxious about those things that haven't happened yet. Things that are in the future. Things that might happen. We might worry about what happens around the next corner. and we're tempted to be anxious about the unknown. And of course, we face the troubles of today, of each present day. Jesus talked about this in Matthew 6:25 when he was teaching on not worrying. When he was talking about not worrying about what might come in the future, because each day has its own, has enough trouble of its own. And so we can live in all of those dimensions. We can need comfort in each one of those areas. As believers and followers of Jesus, we have need of comfort. And so God created us with that capacity to both be comforted, but also to comfort others. But he also sets us up in the place, or sets himself up in the place, of being the God of all comfort, the one who can bring peace and comfort to us in all of those challenges, in all of those difficulties, whether in the past, whether now, right, we're facing in the present, or whether something in the future. No matter what the challenge, no matter what the difficulty is, God is there for us. God is near to us. He is the God of all comfort and the Father of compassion. As we receive God's comfort, we can have true freedom from fear, true freedom from pain and from guilt. In his mercy and love, God is eager and ready to provide for us of all kinds of comfort to any of his children in all kinds of circumstances. Because we know that whatever we face, our God knows the situation. He is close to us. He's near to us. He sent Jesus to us to be Emmanuel, God with us. And he continues to be with us by his Holy Spirit. The fact that God is the God of all comfort teaches us that all comfort ultimately comes from God. We might find other sources that might temporarily comfort us or comfort us a little bit, but there's only one source of true and lasting and ultimate comfort, and that's God himself. And so he invites us to come to him, to bring our difficulties, to bring our sadness, to bring our burdens to him, so that we can be free, so we can be comforted by him. The amazing part as well about that passage in 2 Corinthians is that this comfort is not just for us. It's not something that we can just take and keep for ourselves. Because the comfort that we, as believers and followers of Jesus, receive is to flow through us to others. So that, as 2 Corinthians 1:4 says, so that we can comfort those in any trouble with the comfort we ourselves have received from God. Just like grace, comfort is an active, powerful gift that comes ultimately from God and is given to us, but is not intended to stay with us. It's intended to be given to others who are in need of it. And so we see the Bible, and Jesus in particular, commending those who simply spend time with people, who go and visit those who are sick or those who are in prison and bring comfort to them. That's what we're to be about. To share the comfort that we have, to share the peace that we have through God, through the Father of compassion, through the God of all comfort. And in bringing comfort to those in trouble, we're really glorifying God. We're pointing to God. We're saying, this comfort doesn't come from me. It doesn't come from myself, but I'm giving to you what God has given to me. And you can go to God for that too. You can receive this. You can have relationship with this God of all comfort. In the end, when we finally leave these temporary troubles of this life and enter into the permanent joy that is there for us next after this life is over, our Heavenly Father will comfort us each one last time, wiping away every tear. Because we know that he's going to welcome us into a world where comfort's no longer needed. Because there is no more death or mourning or crying or pain, for the old order of things has passed away. That's what Revelation 21:4 says. We will enjoy this God of all comfort forever, not needing to be comforted because there's no trouble, there's no hardship there. But for now, let's remember that in our difficulties, that in our worries, that in our hardships and trials, that we are not alone. That the God of all comfort is near to us, and he comforts us in our troubles. And that same God of all comfort invites us to share what we have received with those around us. In all these things, may God teach us that whatever our lot, we can still say, it is well with my soul. I want to close this time by just praying with you, praying for you. I've not met any of you personally, and with the pandemic realities happening right now, I don't know that I will in the near future, but just know that there are people in our church, in the Kingsfield Zurich Mennonite Church, who do know you, and who care about you, and who love you and are praying for you. And I just want to join with them in praying blessing on you, praying that you will find this God of all comfort in your challenges, you'll find the joy in the good things, and that you will know that God is near, and that you are loved by him, and loved by the people at Kingsfield Zurich. God, thank you for your word. Thank you for your presence, that you are near to us, and that you're always there ready to provide for us the comfort and the peace that we need. God, I pray for my sisters and brothers at the Blue Water home. God, you know them by name. You know them personally. You know what their needs and what the challenges are they're going through, the struggles. And so, God, I pray in Jesus' name that you would be close to them, that you would provide them with your comfort, and that they would recognize that you are the source. You're the only one who can give true and lasting comfort. So God, bless them. I pray where there is sickness that you would heal. I pray where there is sickness of heart, whether it's from loss of loved one, loss of things that they value in their life, or just sadness of not being able to see loved ones the way that we have before this pandemic took place. God, whatever that sickness is, I pray, God, you would be the healer, that you would provide. And God, I pray that as they lift their eyes to you, and as they listen to your word, that they would be encouraged and comforted, and God, that you would be a blessing to them, that you would bless them and as well make them a blessing to others. So God, be close. You know, you say in your word that you know even before a prayer request is out of our mouths, you already know it and have angels moving towards to do your will, to answer that prayer. And so God, thank you that I don't need to know what the exact needs are, that you already do. So God, would you meet these folks where they're at? Bless them, and may they know your goodness. I pray these things all in Jesus' name. Amen. God bless you, friends. Take care today. Be blessed and be a blessing.